परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने ओमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीसिद्धगणेशाय नमो मह्यम्। सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठान बुद्धि बोध्य बुद्धेर्कृत्व निर्मलं अपारं सर्वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव अहं नमत्वन्यत इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। कंटिन्यूइंग द द्वितीय तरंगा, we are looking at the objections to aikya. Basically the vishaya is aikya between jiva and brahma. So we saw a set of objections saying that jiva has sukha dukha, so baddha jiva, whereas brahma is mukta, nitya mukta. How can there be aikya between the two? And jivas are aneka. If there is aikya, then there would be sukha dukha pratiti of other jivas also. If one has sukha dukha, the other should also have, but anubhavasya abhavat, anubhava abhavat anekaha jivaha. Then there was an analysis, some technical discussion on that, to establish that there is a sakshi who has not been completely established yet, but Purva Pakshi himself says that I know what you are going to answer. You are going to say that this sakshi is different from this samsari jiva, but even if we accept the sakshi as different from the jiva, whether you call him the jiva as pratibimba, pratibimbita chaitanya, or as abhasa, however you call this, or like the ghatakasha, in whichever you term this jiva as, that jiva would be aneka, and if you consider sakshi as different from jiva, even sakshis have to be aneka, because otherwise we'll have sakshi pratyaksha also. Sukha dukha, which are in Vedanta, are sakshi pratyaksha. So if sukha dukha are sakshi pratyaksha, still aneka sakshis have to be accepted, because one sakshi having sukha dukha pratiti also, or the anubhava, pratyakshatvam of sukha dukha to the sakshi is with considering only one jiva or one sharira, one antakarana, and not many. We don't have sakshi anubhava across antakaranas either. Therefore, aneka sakshis should be accepted. And if you accept aneka sakshi, then aneka sakshinam ekena brahmana aikya asambhavaha. So this is what we have landed on, the 60th point here, where sadhu says evam cha antakkarana tad dharmanam kevala sakshi vedyattvam vedyattvamate. So if you say kevala sakshi vedya is this antakkarana and antakkarana dharmas, kevala sakshi vedya, known only to the sakshi. Not basically what it means is that it is not known through the sense organs and with the antakkarana along with the sense organs. Antakkarana does not have to go through the sense organs to get a particular ghatakara patakara vritti. Everything is actually revealed to the sakshi, but in this particular case there is no use of sense organs. That's what it really means in Siddhanta. But in any case, sakshis are to be accepted as many, and the sadhu says that we are not discussing this right now. I'll explain who the sakshi is and how this aikya is possible after I hear you out. So he says, I agree that sakshis have to be many as per your argument. That is fine with me. We don't have any issue with that. So he didn't discuss that point. Now when it is said aneka sakshinam ekena brahmana ekya sambhava, there he says evam cha antakrana tad dharmanam kevala sakshi vedyatva mate sakshinah ekatva angikaro na yujyate. Sakshi cannot be one. And this was discussed earlier. So he says purvam eva pradarshita rītya ekena sakshina yada एकांतकरणस्त सुखदुःखादयः विषयीक्रियन्ते तदा सर्वांतकरणगत सुखदुःखादेरपि विषयीकरणापत्तेः विषयाकरणापत्तेः अनिवार्य अनिवार्यत्वात् इट इज अनिवार्य यू कैनॉट कैनॉट एक्सप्लेन हाउ we don't have a sakshi does not have an experience of other sukha dukha if all sakshis are one with brahma. So that kind of an objection cannot be avoided. You cannot avoid that question, nor can you answer it. Thereby you have to accept sakshis are many, and accepting sakshis are many, you have to accept that cannot be eka with brahma. So further he says kriyante tada sorry vishay anirvarya anivaryatvat loke tatha ananubhavat aneke sakshina iti eva abhyupagantavyam. So since there is no anubhav of other sukha dukha for the sakshi, now from jiva we have shifted the objection to sakshi, nothing different there. So he says the objections continue. Jiva does not have anubhav. You say sakshi has anubhav. Okay, sakshi has anubhav. What about sakshi having no anubhava of other sukha dukha? It establishes many sakshis. Therefore, sakshina anekatva pakshe yathana dosha tatha uktam eva prak. So there is siddhanti. To the siddhanti, the purva pakshi has said that you can't point out a flaw because I am picking these arguments from your own granthas, your own siddhanta. So your Vedanta siddhanta says that sakshis have to be many, otherwise sukha dukha cannot be experienced. Sukha dukha of others also need to be experienced, and anubhavasya abhavat you have to accept many sakshis. Tatha cha aneka sakshinam ekena brahmana aikyam na yujyate. Thereby once you accept many sakshis, you cannot have all sakshis being one with brahma. So vishay vishayakshepana samadhanani. Now these objections which were raised, these are answered. First, we have to know who is the sakshi. You cannot just talk about sakshi and say that they have to be aneka and they cannot be one with Brahma. All these objections are fine only if you know who the sakshi is. Superficially, we agree with your argument, but we don't agree with your conclusion. This is what the Siddhanti is saying. Yaduktam jivaha ragadveshadi klesha vishishtaha tadrahitancha brahma. Okay, this is going to get a little technical. So those who have a background in Tarka, who have studied Vedanta, Paribhasha, Ityadi, it may be easy for them. Others may find a little difficult. I'll try to keep it simple. But if you don't understand the technicality, just let it aside. If you understand the overview, that is sufficient. So yaduktam jivaha ragadveshadi klesha vishishta tadrahitam cha brahma. Jiva is endowed with ragadvesha ityadi, whereas brahma is free from ragadvesha. Tasmat tayoho jiva brahmano aikya rupaha vishayaha granthasya na siddhyet. So your objection on the grantha talking about aikya between jiva and brahma, that is untenable, because there cannot be oneness possible between ragadveshadi man jivaha and raga dvesha rahita brahma. Yadyapi tat satyameva. So superficially it is right. What you are saying is right, says the Siddhanti. Yadyapi tat satyameva tathapi ragadi viyukta sakshinah brahmana aikyam yujyateva. However, we are not talking about aikya between jiva, who you know as being identified with the antakkarana which has ragadvesha. However, we are talking about that jiva who is atma in swarupa, who is Brahmatma in Swarupa and who has nothing to do with this identified Jiva, who has come up as a Mithya entity due to Pratibimba or however you, due to, it is an Abhasa, however you take it, this Jiva, which you are talking about as being endowed with Sukha Dukha, is not the one we are talking about as being one with Brahma. Because that is a Mithya entity which has cropped up. It's a reflection. The reflection can said to be having no Satta other than the Brahma, can be said to be completely Abhinna from Brahma and not tainted by the attributes of the Upadhi. He has nothing to do with the dusty mirror. If the reflection, the original is not tainted, nor is the reflection really. But there is a pratiti of the reflection not being clear and you think that all the dust is for the reflection. So far if we agree that paksha, then agree with that paksha, then we are not talking about that reflection being one. If you think that that reflection is tainted, fine, let it be. We are not talking about him. We are talking about the Sakshi, the one who is reflected, is actually Brahma. The Sakshi who witnesses this is one with Brahma. So there, he says, this Sakshi is Ragadi Vyukta. He is free from Ragadvesha Ityadi, and that Sakshi who is not really the subject or the object. The witness is different from the subject and object. That Sakshi can be one with Brahma because he is Ragadi Vyukta and Ragadi Rahita, and Brahma is also Ragadi Rahita. Nacha kartrutva bhoktrutva adi dharma vishishta jivad anyaha sakshi vandhyasunu samatvat nasti iti vachyam. And Siddhanti tells the Purupakshi, now you cannot argue here is that there is no sakshi different from jiva. If you have accepted that the jiva is kartrutva bhoktrutva adi dharma vishishta, he is endowed with dharma such as kartrutva bhoktrutva, karta bhokta jiva, if you accept jiva brahma ivanapara, we have no arguments. If you say they know the jiva is karta bhokta, then we have an argument that there is a sakshi who is different from this karta bhokta jiva. Actually there is nothing other than the tattva brahma. So this differentiation between sakshi and jiva is also at the level of this discussion, where technically, you have to say that who is identified, who is not identified, how there are multiple jivas, all this is a prakriya. So with the prakriya bheda, we have to talk about, if you accept the jiva to be karta bhokta samsari, then one who, the same jiva who identifies with the kartrutva bhoktrutvam because of ahankara, becomes individualized, identifies with the koshas, pancha koshas or three shariras, and then becomes a samsari jiva. That jiva is definitely a samsari, whereas sakshi is separate. Who is the sakshi? The sakshi is Shuddha Chaitanya really, who does not bind himself with the sharira to become a jiva. So there are no two entities really. When you shift your cognition from the identified jiva as I am this samsari jiva because I have dukkha, I have these flaws in the sharira, and then become a shariri, which shariri? Not a shuddha shariri chaitanya, but the transmigrating shariri. If you consider yourself as transmigrating from one sharira to another, from one avastha to another, and thereby become a karta bhokta, try to avoid dukkha and get sukha, then you have identified with yourself as this samsari jiva, not as jivatma, who is really atma. In jiva, when you see yourself as a shariri, the atma is lost. So therefore, we call that entity as a jiva. But when you say that I am not a samsari with viveka, when you differentiate between the Atma and Anatma, I and with shruti pramana you establish yourself as different from the sharira atma. You can never be one with the sharira anatma, then you are a sakshi. So the same jiva becomes a jivatma as a sakshi or as a jiva who is a samsari. Thereby, now the question is, if you say that there is a sakshi who is different, then the Purvapakshi may argue that there is no sakshi different from jiva. Really, there is no sakshi different from jiva, but then there is no jiva. Jiva is mithya. Jiva as in that jivatvam is mithya. Jiva is mithya. When I say jiva is mithya, it is not like jagan mithya. Jiva sharira is mithya. Therefore, jivatva bhava is mithya. And then we say that the jiva is just a nama, which is mithya because the rupa which he has taken is mithya. The nama rupatmaka jagat, the sharira belongs to that jagat being mithya, the sharira is mithya, sharira traya is mithya, and thereby the jiva who is popped up as an individual samsari is mithya. Sakshi is shuddha brahma really. So now if the Purvapakshi argues that nacha kartrutva bhoktrutva adi dharma vishishta jivad anyaha sakshi vandhyasuna samatvat nasti iti vachyam, like the vandhya putra, vandhyasunu is vandhya putra, like a son of a barren woman, you cannot argue that such an entity does not exist. Similarly, sakshi does not exist different from jiva. You should not argue that, says the Siddhanti. Why? Who is sakshi? Upahitasya sakshitva. Because this upahita chaitanyam is sakshi. This is a definition. So here it gets technical now. Where the sharira is visheshana to the chaitanya, then that visheshana is vyavartakam. Vyavartakam visheshana. That which differentiates one from the other is a visheshana. There can be another which can differentiate as well. Need not be a visheshana. It is also vyavartaka, but it does not have anvaya. It is not kriya anvayi. That is called as upadhi. So an upadhi can also differentiate. Upadhi is that which differentiates, but does not tag along. It is not... does not have Nitya Sanyoga. Whereas the Visheshana has Nitya Sanyoga. Visheshana tags along and remains along. So if you say Neelam Utpalam and you differentiate it from say Raktam Utpalam or Shuklam Utpalam. So you differentiate different lotuses based on Visheshana, which is Rupa here. So if you look at the color red, you know, blue or you know, white, and we say that the lotus is different, we differentiate lotus by qualifying it by with a color. So this adjective which is qualifying and differentiating the lotuses, that sits along with the lotus. You cannot separate it out. Visheshana is there along with it. However, upadhi need not be. Upadhi is like the, in the crystal, there are two crystals kept and there is one red rose next to the first crystal. Then the first crystal, without even any association, just by placing the red rose next to the crystal, which is clear, both crystals are clear, but then you keep the red rose, which does not even touch the first crystal, but has its color, which reflects into the crystal appears red, it's a translucent stuff, therefore it appears red. Now that red appearance is there, pratiti is there, and that helps differentiate the crystal as red crystal versus the clear crystal. The second crystal is clear, the first crystal, the spatika, is red. But it is real, is it really red? It is not. Sometimes it may appear red, and then when it is not in close proximity with the rose, or if the light situation changes, then it may not appear red. Thereby, it is an upadhi, the red rose, the red color of the rose which the crystal partakes does not really partake. It is a pratiti, pratiti matra. And pratiti matra tvad upadhi, it is just an upadhi, and that crystal will remain pure no matter how the upadhi is, whether it is red or whether it is neela, however it is, the first crystal has no association. Like the second crystal, it is free. It just helps you differentiate, but then this redness does not belong to the crystal. So that is the difference between a visheshana and an upadhi. Thereby the kartrutva bhoktrutvadi dharma visheshta. If you, the entity thinks that I have this sharira, it is a visheshana. That jiva cannot see the jivatva, cannot see oneself without the jivatva. And what is that jivatva? Jivatva is kartrutva bhoktrutva. Being a visheshana, kartrutva bhoktrutva being visheshanas, this jiva has become limited. Whereas Sakshi does not have any of this kartrutva bhoktrutvadi. These are all antakkarana dharmas. Antakkarana may or may not be there for a Sakshi, but Sakshi remains separate. The jiva, which jiva? Samsari jiva, kartrutva bhoktrutva visheshta jiva, cannot remain without kartrutva bhoktrutva. So he will always be there. That jivatvam is due to that. So there is a nitya sambandha. Visheshana and visheshta jiva, they are together. Kartrutva bhoktrutva is tied up with this jiva, and jiva cannot be separated out. They are together. Whereas Sakshi is sometimes seen with this jiva, sometimes not with this jiva. He just separates by antakkarana. You can make bheda, saying that there are nana sakshis. So one antakkarana is making one sakshi, another antakkarana making another sakshi, and therefore aneka sakshi argument of the Purvapakshi is valid. However, that sakshi has nothing to do with these antakkaranas. He has absolutely nothing to do with any of these antakkaranas, as those are upadhis. They are not visheshanas to the sakshi. So aneka sakshis are agreeable. However, the kartrutva bhoktrutva is not an attribute of the sakshi. It is attribute of the jiva. So if you say that the sakshi is not separate, you should not argue that way, because the same jiva, when he looks upon this kartrutva bhoktrutva as not as visheshanas, he separates himself out, then he is a sakshi. So upaitasya sakshitva, meaning the upadhi, sakshi is one who has all of that the jiva thinks as visheshana. Basically antakkarana, we can take to simplify antakkarana as an upadhi instead of as a visheshana. So kartrutva bhoktrutvadi rupa samsari visheshananam yo visheshyamshah sa eva sakshi ityuchyate. So this visheshya chaitanya, the noun, the substantial, the substance is really sakshi chaitanyam, whereas the visheshanas are this kartrutva bhoktrutva samsari. All these are the samsari visheshanas. They are not the chaitanya visheshanas. So visheshya is chaitanya sakshi, sakshi chaitanya, whereas this samsari visheshanas, these kartrutva bhoktrutvadi rupa are these samsari visheshanas. So I have already explained this, so we can go a little faster here now. That visheshana and visheshya have to be differentiated. Visheshya, when visheshanas are added, that visheshya remains with the visheshana. However, when you separate the visheshya, then that mithya entity who is visheshta goes away, and sakshi remains shuddha, who cannot be anymore called as visheshya also, because that visheshana, those visheshanas have made him a visheshya. Adjectives show that this noun can be differentiated. And if there are two nouns, if there are two, say there are two Ramas. So Rama is a noun. Rama is actually the padartha. Pada padartha yo nitya sambandha. Now there are two Ramas. How do you differentiate? You say one carries a dhanushya bana, who is Sitapati Ramaha. So you talk about Sitapati Rama or Dhanushya carrying Rama. Dhanushya Yukta Ramaha Dasharatihi. So that is one Rama. The other Rama is Parashurama. So Parashu Yukta Ramaha, Parashurama. We can differentiate. So Tadrusha Sakshi Nishede Samsarinaha Visheshyamsha Palape Kartru Bhuktru Swarupa Samsari Nishedeva Paryavaset. Now, if the Purvapakshi has argued the way he has argued earlier, that this धर्म विशिष्ट कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व आदि धर्म विशिष्ट जीवाद अन्य साक्षी नास्ति। इफ यू से दैट वंद्या पुत्रवत देन यू शुड नॉट आर्ग्यू न च वाच्यम इति न च वाच्यम सेज द सिद्धांति। वाई इफ यू डू दैट देन व्हाट विल हैपन इज दैट देयर वोंट बी अ संसारी एट ऑल। साक्षी शुद्ध चैतन्य विशेष अंश एंड इफ यू डू नॉट एड विशेषणस एंड मेक हिम अ जीवा देन देयर विल बी नो संसारी। सो कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व स्वरूप संसारी निषेधे पर्यवसे। इफ यू डिनाय साक्षी एज अ सेपरेट एंटिटी देन साक्षी निषेधे किं भवति। साक्षी निषेधे कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व स्वरूप संसारी निषेध भवति पर्यवसेत। यू लैंड इन संसारी निषेध। सो संसरणम इज नॉट देयर, देयर इज नो संसारी एट ऑल बिकॉज शुद्ध चैतन्य कैनॉट बी संसारी। एंड इफ यू डिनाय that there cannot be a sakshi that is equivalent to denying shuddha chaitanya, then there will be no samsari. And since samsari is there, you have to accept that shuddha chaitanya is there who binds and becomes a sakshi. Why so? He explains further. Ekasyeva chaitanyasya sakshitve vivakshite antakrana upadir bhavati. When the same chaitanya is intended to be talked about as this Chaitanya as Sakshi, Sakshitve Vivakshite, Antakkaranam Upadhi Bhavati. That time Antakkaran is an Upadhi. Sometimes he takes it on, sometimes we can see this Chaitanya without the association. We can understand this Chaitanya without the association. This Jivatva Bhava Yukta Chaitanya cannot be talked about within the Visheshanas of Kartrutva Bhoktrutva. He is a Samsari. He has samsara visheshas. Samsarana visheshas are there. Tasyeva kartrutva bhoktrutva visishta jivatve vyokshite antakrana visheshanam cha bhavati. When will antakrana become a visheshana? When the vyoksha is to talk about that same chaitanya. There is no other chaitanya. There is only one chaitanya. There is no pramana. It has been shown earlier and established that there is no pramana for chaitanya to be nana. There is no pramana for dvitiya chaitanya, let alone nana. That's why Advitiya Chaitanya is one without a second. So the same Chaitanya is talked about as Sakshi and as Jiva. When is it a Sakshi? When Antakkaranam is talked about as an Upadhi. That's when we say that he is Sakshi. And when Antakkarana becomes a Visheshana, then he becomes a Jiva. So you can land in both ways. Whether when you are talking about Jiva, Chaitanya is Jiva, that time we include this kartrutva bhoktrutva. When we exclude it, then we are talking about the sakshi. Visheshanena yuktam visishtam upadina yuktam upahitam iti cha uchyate. So what is this visishta jiva? Visishta chaitanya kartrutva bhoktrutva visishta is equal to jiva chaitanya. So kartrutva bhoktrutva visishta chaitanyam is equal to jivaha. And kartrutva bhoktrutva उपहितम चैतन्यम साक्षी। व्हाट इज द डिफरेंशिएशन? विशेषणेन युक्तम, विशेषणेन युक्तम विशिष्टम, दैट इज विशिष्टम, एंड उपाधिना युक्तम उपहितम। दिस इज द डेफिनेशन, वेरी क्लियर, नोवेयर हैज इट बीन एक्सप्लेन सो क्लियरली। सो नाउ दिस इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड दैट साक्षी कैन बी डिफरेंट। एंड नाउ टू एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज दिस, आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड दिस यू नो उपाधि ऑल्सो, देन he explains further. Karya ananvayi, karya ananvayatve sati vidyamanatve sati vyavartaka upadhi. What is upadhi? Karya ananvayatve, ananvayatve sati vidyamanatve sati, meaning while being existent vyavartaka, that which differentiates that existent entity, existent in the sense vyavaharika satta, that which is there and separates, differentiates something by not having anvaya in the karya. In the karya, after differentiating, it goes away. It has nothing to do with being along with the karya. Or it does its job and goes away. Differentiation job. It does not continue. It does not have anvaya further. That is an upadhi. So here in the Tippana edition, yadvastu swasamipastham vastvantaram vyavartayati apitu swayam tenana sambadhyate स उपाधि इत्युच्यते. सो व्हाट इज एन उपाधि? दैट विच डिफरेंशिएट्स अनदर वस्तु नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट टू इट नियर बाय बट डज नॉट कनेक्ट विद दैट इज अ इट इज हेल्पफुल ओनली टू डिफरेंशिएट बट इट हैज नो कनेक्शन विद द डिफरेंशिएटेड दैट इज एन उपाधि. एंड स्वात्मना सह एव वस्तुना औभाषकं विशेषणम् इत्युच्यते विच कंटिन्यूज टू हैव संबंध विद द वस्तु दैट इज कॉल्ड एज विशेषण. सो क्रिया अन्वय इज देर इन द विशेषण विद एंड द क्रिया अन्वय इज नॉट देर कार्य विद द कार्य बेसिकली थ्रू द क्रिया इन टू द कार्य इट डज नॉट हैव संबंध दैट इज एन उपाधि इट हैज डिफरेंशिएटेड द अदर ऑल्सो डिफरेंशिएट विशेषण but it has an anvaya in the kriya and lands on the karya also. So that is the simple explanation. So he gives a nyayamata example because there is a nyaya objection, tarkika's objection, nyaya vaisheshika. So yatha nyayamate karna golakantargata akasha shrotrendriyam iti uchyate. So they have a definition. What is shrotrendriya? The sense organ of hearing. It is akasha which is karna golaka antargata. Which is there in the karna golaka, in the ears, in the physical ear, there is akasha within, and that is shrotrendriya. But is it karna golaka necessary there? Karna golaka, is it connecting with the shrotrendriya? No, it is just segmenting the akasha, differentiating the akasha, and that's where shrotrendriyam is. Okay, we have got the definition. Karna golaka is upadhi. तत्र कर्णगोलकम् श्रोत्रस्य उपाधि यतः कर्णगोलकम् स्वावच्छिन्नम् आकाशम् श्रोत्रेन्द्रियत्वेन बोधयित्वा स्वयं तेन असंबद्धं भवति. दिस कर्णगोलक डज नॉट हैव एसोसिएशन आफ्टर डिफरेंशिएटिंग द आकाश एज श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय इट इज नॉट कनेक्टेड टू द श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय आफ्टर दैट इट हैज प्लेड इट्स रोल बट इट इज एन उपाधि इट डज नॉट हैव एनी संबंध विद द श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय लेटर आफ्टर डिफरेंशिएटिंग द आकाश तस्मात् कर्णगोलकम् श्रोत्रस्य उपाधि. दैट्स व्हाई कर्णगोलक इज उपाधि फॉर द श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय. एवं अन्तःकरणपि सोपहितं चैतन्यं साक्षित्वेन बोधयित्वा स्वयं तेन असंबद्धं वर्तते. सिमिलरली दिस अन्तःकरण डिवाइड्स द चैतन्य एज साक्षी इंडिविजुअल साक्षी बट देन हैविंग शोन दिस इंडिविजुअलिटी ऑफ द साक्षी डज नॉट कनेक्ट विद द साक्षी एट ऑल दैट साक्षी चैतन्य रिमेन्स सेपरेट. The karya which is created with a name as Sakshi, which is given for the Chaitanya itself, now said to be segmented due to Antakkarana, but Antakkarana is not connected to the Sakshi at all. Just like that rose which is separate, the redness of the rose is also separate from the crystal. That differentiates the crystal but does not have karyanvaya. It does not really make the crystal red. सिमिलरली सो तस्माद् अन्तःकरणं साक्षिणः उपाधि इति इति सिद्ध्यति. अन्तःकरणस्थ चैतन्यमात्रं साक्षी इति च सिद्ध्यति. सो अन्तःकरण इज द उपाधि फॉर द साक्षी एंड अन्तःकरणस्थ चैतन्यमात्रं इज साक्षी. व्हाट इज द चैतन्य? इट इज विद इन द अन्तःकरण जस्ट लाइक इन द न्यायमत देर इज आकाश विद इन द कर्णगोलक बट इट हैज नो कनेक्शन विद द कर्णगोलक. आकाश हैज नो संबंध रियली. आकाश कैनॉट हैव संबंध विद दी कर्णगोलक. सिमिलरली चैतन्य कैनॉट हैव एनी संबंध. हियर वी कैन गो फर्दर एंड से सत्ता इटसेल्फ इज डिफरेंट बट वी डोंट टॉक अबाउट सत्ता विद न्याय राइट नाउ. वी एक्सप्लेन देयर एग्जाम्पल. इन देयर एग्जाम्पल आकाश डज इट हैव संबंध विद दी कर्णगोलक? नो. श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय डज नॉट. इट्स डिफरेंशिएट्स हेल्प टू डिफरेंशिएट टू अंडरस्टैंड द डेफिनेशन बट बियॉन्ड दैट इट हैज नो संबंध. Now, what is the jiva? Sakshi Swarupa is known. That Sakshi is Shuddha Chaitanya, who is Antakkaranastha, is in the Antakkarana, but has no sambandha with the Antakkarana. Antakkarana has just managed to differentiate this Chaitanya as being located in a place, whereas there is no real location. Particularly, you cannot say there is a location. It is an upadhi. That is an upadhi. Jiva Swarupa, what is Jiva Swarupa? Here, jiva swarupam karya karyanvayatve sati vidyamanatve sati vyavartakam visheshanam. What is visheshana? That existent, you know, the something that is there which separates, differentiates like earlier, but also through the karya it associates and lands itself on the karya also. You cannot take it out. Yatha kundali agataha ityatra kundalam asyasti iti kundali. one who has the earrings, somebody is wearing earrings, that person is a kundali. Some example, you can take any example. So now that person, if you say the person is a kundali, then he has to have kundala. You cannot call someone a kundali without a kundala. Dandi, dandi purusha, danda asti asti dandi. So that danda, he has to be carrying a danda. Dandi means sannyasi. A dandi sannyasi is a dandi sannyasi only when he is carrying the danda. Otherwise, you can call him a sannyasi, but you cannot call him a dandi. There are different types of sannyasas where some do not carry danda. So you can call a person dandi only if he has danda. Without the danda, he is not dandi. Similarly, without the kundala, he is not kundali. And so too, without the visheshana, he is not a visheshya. Without the samsara anvaya, there is no samsari ityatra. So in the example, yatha kundali agata ityatra, kundalam visheshanam, kundala is a visheshana. So visheshtasyaiva purushasya agamana kriya kartrutvena bodhakatvat. That agataha means, oh, he has come, kundali has come. Meaning what? The one who has kundala has come. So the kundalam has to come in the agamana kriya. When you say kundali agata in the agamana kriya, in the arriving kriya, the kundalam should come along. You cannot say that, oh, kundalam was there, now it is not there. He is no longer a kundali. Then you cannot say kundali agataha. When you say the kundali has come, then you know that the kundalam has tagged along as a visheshana. So swa visheshtasya means kundala visheshtasyeva. Swa is kundalam there. Kundalam is visheshanam and kundala visheshana visheshtasya eva purushasya agamana kriya kartrutvena bodhakatvat. It is the shabda bodha there is when you say kundali agataha, the shabda bodha is basically vakya bodha. Shabda bodha takes place as the kundala has come along with the kundali. Otherwise, it does not make sense. The sentence is not meaningful. Therefore, there kundalam is visheshana. Yatha va neelam ghatam apashyam. Oh, I saw a neela ghata. If I make that statement, ityatra neela varnaha visheshanam. Ghatasya iva neela varnasya api darshana kriyayam karmatvena anvayat. When I say apashyam, langlakaraha, uttam purusha ek vachana, I saw, there is an akanksha. Kimapashyam aham, what did I see? So karma akanksha is there. And when I say, I answer, ghatam, I saw ghata, ghatam apashyam. Then what type of ghata did I see? I saw neelam ghatam. So neelam apashyam, ghatam apashyam. Thereby neelam ghatam apashyam. There neela is also seen as karma. In the sentence, when I say I saw, what did I see? I saw neela, I saw dark ghata. So I saw the ghata and the dark also. Because the darkness of the ghata, the neela is also translated as blue at times, but it is actually dark color. So neelam, let's take blue also. I saw the blueness also with the ghata. So neelam apashyam, ghatam apashyam, there is an anvaya. When I make an anvaya, when I say ghatam apashyam, tidrasham ghatam apashyam, neelam ghatam apashyam. So neelam apashyam, ghatam apashyam. Neelam has anvaya with apashyam. Thereby, darshana kriyayam karmatvena anvaya. There is a karmatva anvaya with apashyam in the darshana kriya. Therefore, neela is a visheshana. Tatha antakkaranam api kartrutva bhoktrutva visishta jiva chaitanyasya visheshanam. Similarly, kartrutva bhoktrutva is there in this as visheshana in the jiva chaitanya. One who is jiva, the chaitanya which is qualified by kartrutva bhoktrutva, that chaitanya is called as jiva. They become visheshana. Without them, you cannot say the chaitanya is jiva at all. Swavachinna chaitanya kartrutva bhoktrutva vyavahara vyavaharaspadatvasya bodhanat. Because when you talk about this jiva, दिस चैत बेसिकली चैतन्य जीव इज चैतन्य यू डोंट से दैट दिस शरीर इज चैतन्य कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व आर क्वालिटीज विच आर नॉट दिस धर्मास आर नॉट चैतन्य हु इज चैतन्य द जीव इज चैतन्य नाउ दिस चैतन्य हु इज गिवन अ नेम एज जीव वेन कैन यू गिव इट स्वावच्छिन्न चैतन्ये कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व व्यवहारास्पदत्वस्य बोधनात् स्वावच्छिन्न कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व विशिष्ट जीव ई स्व स्वावच्छिन्न चैतन्य विच इज दिस अवच्छिन्न इज विशेषण वेन द विशेषण इज एडेड देन ओनली यू कैन सेपरेट आउट दिस कर्ता भोक्ता चैतन्य विच अदरवाइज कैन नॉट बी दैट्स व्हाई वी गिव इट अ नेम एज जीव तस्मात् संसारिणः जीवस्य अंतःकरणं विशेषणम् देयर बाय अंतःकरण इज अ विशेषण जीव जीव चैतन्य इट्स अ नेम सो चैतन्य गेट्स अ नेम एज जीव ओनली वेन देर इज अंतकरण एज अ विशेषण नॉट एज एन उपाधि वेन इट इज एन उपाधि देन ही इज साक्षी तथा च अंतकरण तदवच्छिन्न चैतन्यम च एकीकृत्य संसारी इति व्यपदेश सो वेन यू टॉक अबाउट अ संसारी यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट जीव चैतन्य हु हैज विशेषणाज ऑफ कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व देयरफॉर अंतकरण along with this chaitanya who has his visheshanas of kartrutva bhoktrutva that is a samsari iti vyapadesha that is what the shastra points out that is a ekikrutya putting them together antakarna and this chaitanya which is visishta chaitanya kartrutva bhoktrutva visishta chaitanya that is avachinna that entity is called as samsari अयं च उत्तरत्र स्पष्टीक्रियते इट विल बी मेड क्लियर फर्दर व्हेन मोर डिटेल्ड डिस्कशन टेक प्लेस व्हेन There is real teaching going on. This is discussion. The teaching is a discussion with Vishaya. In fact, we are still in Anubandha Chatushtaya. Anubandha Chatushtaya is analyzed in detail in the second chapter. And in that, the Vishaya as a part of the Anubandha Chatushtaya happens to be Jivaikya Brahma. To this, the objections are raised. And here itself, the analysis of Sakshi Ityadi is going on. Just to show that if the Sakshi is cannot be one with Brahma, then how can you have this text? Why make Grantharambha? This is the Purva Paksha. So that is being discussed. When it will be taught from the, in fact, not even the third chapter also, but the same thing, there will be detailed analysis, but from fourth chapter onwards, there will be proper teaching, systematic teaching, of Guru to the Shishya, Uttam Adhikari, Ityadi. There are different Adhikaris who are taught. So in the fourth chapter onwards, all this will be more clear. It may be clear in this chapter itself because the topic does crop up a little here and there, but there is no detailed analysis. In fact, this is detailed enough. This kind of a detailed analysis is not done in any other Grantha. Even at the Tika levels, we don't find so much elaboration. Here, there is a lot of elaboration done. It is quite good. Now, having shown that the Sakshi is separate, the objection that the Sakshis are many and they cannot be one with Brahma are taken up for discussion. Aikyopapattihi. The Aikya between Sakshi and Brahma, whether Aneka Sakshi or not, Aikya with Brahma is definitely possible. How so? Ragadveshadeha kleshaha samsarini eva vartante. Samsarini eva vartante. सो संसारिण्येव रागद्वेषादय क्लेशा वर्तन्ते न तु साक्षिणी इन दि साक्षी देर आर नो रागद्वेष दिस हैज बीन शोन रागद्वेष युक्त जीव इज संसारी रागद्वेष वियुक्त साक्षी इज असंसारी सॉरी जस्ट गिव मी वन मोमेंट सॉरी तत्रापि संसारिणः विशेषणीभूत अंतकरणमेव आश्रितास्ते फर्दर दिस रागद्वेषाद वेर डू दे रेस्ट अपॉन व्हाट डू दे रेस्ट अपॉन अंतकरण संसारिणः विशेषणीभूत हु इज अ संसारी संसारी इज अ विशिष्ट विशिष्ट चैतन्ये संसारी किम विशिष्ट इज अंतकरण विशिष्ट सो अंतकरण इज विशेषण विच वाज शोन अर्लियर Now this antakarana which is a visheshana, ragadveshas rest in the antakarana which is a visheshana. So they are in the visheshana, not in the vishesha at all. दे आर इन दी अंतकरण दे आर नॉट इन चैतन्य हू इज सेट टू बी साक्षी लेटर सो तत्रापि संसारिण विशेषणीभूत अंतकरणमेव आश्रिता ते रागद्वेषादय क्लेशाः न तु विशेष्यभूत चैतन्यम इन दि विशेष्यभूत चैतन्यम दे डु नॉट रेस्ट संसारिण विशेष्यभूत चैतन्यमेव साक्षी इति व्यवह्रियते एंड वी हैव शोन दैट दि विशेष अंश इन दि संसारी इज चैतन्य विच वेन अंडरस्टूड एज सेपरेट फ्रॉम दि विशेषणास विशेषणास आर अंडरस्टूड एज रियली एज उपाधीज दे आर नॉट विशेषणास एट ऑल देन दि जीवा फ्रीज हिमसेल्फ फ्रॉम दि अंतकरण विच इज सीन एज हिज ओन यू नो दिस नो दिस इज मी ही सेपरेट्स हिमसेल्फ विथ फ्रॉम दि अहंकार ममकार विद दि शरीराज एंड देन बिकम्स अ साक्षी That Sakshiti Vyavahriyate, that same Vishesha Ausha, which has mixed up with the Visheshanas, when separated out from the Visheshanas cognitively, then we understand that this is a Sakshi. Sakshiti Vyavahriyate. Ekameva Chaitanyam Antakkarana Visheshtan Chet Samsariti Uchyate Tad Virahitam Chet Sakshiti Cha. So same Chaitanya when seen as having अंतकरण एज विशेषण बिकम्स अ संसारी इज कॉल्ड एज अ संसारी एंड विदाउट दैट कॉल्ड एज अ साक्षी दिस वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड फर्दर इट इज शोन इफ यू हैव नॉट अंडरस्टूड सेज द सिद्धांत इन द पूर्व पक्षी द सेम अंतकरण इज देयर इन द जीवा एज अ विशेष अंश एंड वेन दैट विशेषण बिकम्स एन उपाधि दिस सेम विशेष सेपरेट्स आउट एज अ साक्षी दैट साक्षी is not a vishesha even because visheshana itself is not there upadi upahita chaitanya tasma sakshi swarupasya samsarinah vishesha swarupasya cha shabda bhedam vinana kopyarthata bhedah there is no difference in meaning at all the chaitanya is differentiated only by giving a name so he says that tasmat sakshi swarupasya chaitanyasya That Chaitanya, which is Sakshi Swarupa, or Sakshi with Chaitanya Swarupa, however you see it, that Chaitanya, Samsarinaha Vishesha Swarupasya cha. If you compare Sakshi Swarupa and Samsarinaha Vishesha Swarupa, there is no difference. They are one and the same. There is only difference in name. So, when you say that, oh, Jivat Sakshi Nasti Anyaha, we do not have an objection. The way we see your sentence, you see your sentence in a different way and you see an objection. There we say, no, there cannot be a samsari if you do not agree with the sakshi separate. Because sakshi is chaitanya. And if we analyze from our perspective that there is no other chaitanya, there was never a chaitanya separate. It's the same chaitanya getting a name based on visheshana or upadhi. Then we do have a sakshi. तस्मात् साक्षिस्वरूपस्य संसारेण विशेषस्वरूपस्य च शब्दभेदं विना न कोऽप्यर्थतो भेदः देयर इज अ पदभेद नो पदार्थभेद यदि विशेषस्वरूपे अपि क्लेशाः अंगीक्रियेरन् तर्हि साक्षिणोऽपि ते अंगीकृताः स्युः इफ यू एक्सेप्ट दीज क्लेशास कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व कृत रागद्वेषादयः इफ यू एग्री दोज रागद्वेष क्लेशास एज देर एज बीइंग देर इन द विशेष अंश ऑल्सो ऑफ द जीवा देन दे लैंड ऑन द साक्षी ऑल्सो देन ही विल नॉट बी अ साक्षी एट ऑल साक्षी कैन नॉट इंटरमिंगल विद द फ्लॉज ऑफ द साक्ष्यम इफ देर इज समथिंग गोइंग ऑन द स्ट्रीट्स समथिंग यू नो सम फाइट गोइंग ऑन अ साक्षी हु इज वॉचिंग इट यू नो फॉर फन देर आर लॉट ऑफ पीपल पासर्स बाय ओ देर इज अ फाइट गोइंग ऑन एवरीवन एक्साइटेड I mean, if there is a fight going on the street, you can't do anything to separate them out, then stay away. Okay, staying away, but then it is fun to watch for people. You know, some fight going on, it does not affect me. I have nothing to do with the fight. I am not hurt. Let both get hurt, but I am not hurt. Should be Dukkha Rupa, but it is not Dukkha Rupa because I have no association with either. So I sit out and watch. Watch for fun. You know, Krida. So this is the Leela. Sitting out, you are watching, whatever happens there, you are disconnected. If you accept that this Sakshi sitting back and watching the fight is also, you know, having these, he is also hurt. If there is a blow on the somebody's face by the fighters, if one guy throws a punch on the other, if you feel the punch, then you are no longer the witness. You are part of the fight, really. Yadi vishesha swarupe klesha angikriyaran tari sakshino api te angikrita syuhu nachayeta dishtam. That is not desirable. Chaitanya cannot have these laws. Sakshi cheta kevalo nirgunascha, says Shvetashvatara Upanishad. Sakshi cheta kevalaha nirgunascha, chitswarupa ityartha. Kevalaha nirgunaha, cannot have any gunas, cannot have any of these dharmas also. Sakshi is kevala chitswarupa. Na lipyate loka dukhena bahya, says Kathopanishad. Like the Surya. The Surya throws prakasha on the entire world, whether people are fighting or, you know, they are stealing, or if there is dirt in the world, the Surya is unaffected. Na lipyate loka dukhena bahya. Similarly, this Sakshi is not tainted by the sorrows of the world. They are external to the Sakshi. Asangohyayam purushaha. This purusha, purushete itiva puranatva purushaha. The purusha, because he makes everything purna, or he resides in the puri. Puri in the city of these nine gated city of the body, in which there is antakarana, he sits in that. Not really, figurative. Ayam purushaha asangaha. He has no sangha with anything. Everything else because of actually satta bheda, but even then, he does, however you understand, there is no sangha, says the Shruti. Sana sadhuna karmana bhuyan no eva asadhuna kaniyan. The Bharat Mantra says that with sadhu karmas, he does not grow. With asadhu karmas, he does not, you know, perish or become little. Na vardate karmana no kaniyan. Does not grow or shrink with the karmas. Ityadi shrutibhya sakshinaha na klesha gandopyasti iti Vedanta Siddhantat. Vedanta Siddhanta is this. As Shruti says, in keeping with the Shruti, follow the Shruti to the letter, that Sakshi has no klesha gandha. Not even a whiff of klesha is there for the Sakshi. Ataha samsarinaha visheshya swarupena klesha santi. Kintu visheshani bhuta antakkarana matre. So these kleshas are not there in the visheshyamsha of the samsari, which happens to be the Suddha Chaitanya, whom we call as Sakshi, whereas the kleshas are there in the visheshana of the samsari, which is the antakkarana. Kama sankalpo vichikitsa shraddha shraddha dhrutir adhrutir hir dhir bhir ityetas sarvam mana eva, said Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. All of these which are talked about as visheshanas, in the visheshana, visheshana is antakkarana, in the visheshana, antakkarana, which is mana, in those visheshana, in that visheshana antakkarana, all these ragadveshadis rest, not in the chaitanya. They are antakkarana dharma, so which is said, kamaha, sankalpa, vichikitsa, shraddha, ashraddha, dhritihi, adhritihi, hrihi, dhihi, bhihi, ityetat sarvam, mana eva. All these are antakkarana dharmas. Desire, whether making a sankalpa, I'll do this, vichikitsa, inquiring into something, shraddha, ashraddha, dhritihi is there. So trust, whether you trust something, you don't trust, all this is mana. Samshaya is also part of mana. Dhritihi, all the, you know, intellectuality, all that is a part of mana, antakkarana only. So lajja, all the dhairya, all of this fear, everything else, it is upalakshana, you can include everything else. Mana eva kama yasya hridishritaha akam rupam shokantaram tirno hi tada sarvan chokan hridayasya bhavati ityadi shrutibhyaha. There are so many shrutis quoted to say that hridishritaha, hridi antakkarane shritaha kamaha akamam rupam shokantaram. And then so many shrutis, ityadi, so many are there. This shokantaram is akama rupa. Without antakkarana, there is no kama, there is no shoka. Tirno hi tada sarvan shokan hridayasya bhavati. Hridayasya shrokan, natu atmanaha, natu sakshinaha. These shokas, all shokas are crossed over because one crosses over with the sambandha with the hridaya, which is manaha, which is antakarana, which is visheshana to the chaitanya, who is sakshi. Then further, rage ichha sukha dukkhaadi buddhau satyam pravartate shushuptau nasti tannashe tasmad buddhestu natmanah iti vruddha vachanaachya. There is vruddha vachana. There are people who have created granthas, although paurushya, they are vruddha vachanas. We have adara, they are apta vakyas. And they, if we don't understand the shrutis, they tell us in simpler words, in their own creations, ragadeha vruddha vachanaachya, ragadeha buddhi dharma eva, they are antakkarana dharma, natu jivatma dharma ha iti uktam. They are not jivatma dharma. Why? Because raga, ichha, sukha, dukkha, adi, kama krodha ityadi, lobha, moha, buddhau satyam pravartate. Anvaya vyatirika is shown. When buddhi is there, means antakkarana is there, then alone these continue to be there, raga, ichha, ityadi. Shushuptau nasti, in sushupti this buddhi is not active, antakkarana is not active. In swapna and in jagrata avastha it is active, but in shushupti it is not active, and thereby ragadeyaha dharmaha nasti, sushuptau nasti. Ragadeya, raga ichha sukha dukkhadi nasti. In ekavachana you have to use, so sushuptau nasti, or dharmaha nasanti. Tannashe is buddhi nashe. Nashe is nasha adarshana. So in Sushupti there is adarshana of buddhi, antakarana is not known, one is fast asleep, deep asleep, and then these raga ichha ityadi are not there. In fact, their individuality is also not there. Tasmad buddhe hetu na atmanaha, this raga ichha sukha dukha are buddhi dharma, antakarana dharma, not atma dharma. So in the end he says, tatacha antakarana visishtasya jivasya brahmanasa aikya असंभवे अपि अंतकरण उपहित साक्षिणः तत् संभवति एव. सो इफ यू ऑब्जेक्ट दैट द जीवा कैनॉट बी वन विद ब्रह्मा, देन द साक्षी कैन बी वन विद ब्रह्मा, बिकॉज जीवा इज अंतकरण विशिष्ट, वेर एज साक्षी इज नॉट. अंतकरण उपहित इज, अंतकरण इज उपाधि फॉर द साक्षी, वेर एज इट इज विशेषण फॉर द जीवा. सो जीवा कैनॉट बी वन विद ब्रह्मा इफ यू से दैट because of your misunderstanding of the jiva pada, then we'll separate out a sakshi and say chaitanya, who is vishesha ausha in the jiva, he is one with brahma. You cannot object there, sambhavati eva. So this is the last point he made there in 63. We'll look at the 64th avartana in the next part. Sukham nityam saprakasham vyapakam nama rupayo adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddhir dhrityatva nirmalam aparam sarvedanta vedyam pratyak paramah tadeva aham namattonyat iti menishchita matihi. So now anekatva, we'll see anekatva objection of sakshi also, we'll see in the next part. Any questions? Okay, I'll see you next part. Namaste.
Namaste, Prabhu. Namaste.